Station 5, Battalion 81, Squad 81, Station 3, PD 150, 365, 326, 286, be en route, Sherman High School and Moore Street, the front of the school, two-car MVC, multiple injuries. Well, units are en route to you, okay?
Okay.
I'm gonna have you stay on the phone with me until they get there, okay?
Okay. I don't think one of them is breathing.
Two students, Emma and Cody, are arrested by Sherman PD at the scene. One student, Maddie, was taken to the hospital by Sherman Fire Department ambulance. She was treated and released with minor to moderate injuries. One student, Jacob, dies at the scene and is transported by Waldo Funeral Home. One student, Connor, is transported to TMC by AeriVac helicopter with multiple serious injuries. AeriVac is aided by Sherman Fire Department.
We got a 17-year-old male. He was involved in a head-on collision. He has a head laceration, contusions. He does have some chest wounds, abrasions on the legs, blood pressure 80 over PAL, pulse 50, respirations 20, shallow. He does have diminished breath sounds in the right lower lobes.
Anybody have a pulse? All right, pulse starting CPR. You want me to push Effie?
Yes.
Pressure on the Effie in at 854.
Bring the end to me. All right, full TDR. ET2.
What did you call for?
Second Effie. We're starting mass transfusion.
Does anybody have a pulse?
Pulse check.
Any suggestions? Time of death.
As we discussed, we had transported both Connor and Jacob to the ME's office in Dallas, and we haven't received word back yet when we'll be receiving them back here. Have y'all had an opportunity to think about what type of services that you're going to have at this point?
No.
Are you looking at ground burial or cremation? Whichever one y'all decide and make those arrangements for you. Of course, we'll need to pick up caskets, you know, for both of them, and we're going to have a joint service. Why don't we then take a walk back there? If y'all would just follow back to the back. Some are going to be made out of metal, and then we've got some over here that are made out of wood, hardwoods. The price will reflect what the material that they use to construct the casket is in the type of interior. Okay, the City Cemetery, do y'all have family that are buried in another cemetery locally?
They're not even from here.
No, I don't.
Watch Brady legs a little bit for me. Whenever I uncover, put your hand on the wall, okay? Don't move it off the wall. Put that hand down to your side. We're gonna do this one first. Let's have a seat in the back.
This case is the State of Texas versus Emma Morgan, cause number 2022-CR-0912. This case before the court is charged by way of a criminal information. Are the parties ready to proceed?
Yes, Your Honor. The state is ready at this time.
Defense is ready, Your Honor.
Okay. Has the defendant been provided with a copy of the information?
She has, Your Honor. I went over the information with her. She understands what she's charged with.
Okay. Ms. Morgan? You're in court today to be arraigned on the charges in this criminal information that was filed in Grayson County. You understand why you're here?
Yes, Your Honor.
Have you seen the information that was filed in this case?
Yes, Your Honor.
Ma'am, I'm going to read the charges and the information for the record and also make certain that you're put fully on notice about the offenses you have been charged with and the penalties that apply. Ms. Morgan, you're charged in count one of the information with possession of alcoholic beverage in a motor vehicle in violation of Title 10, Section 49.031. 3B. The information alleges that on April 29, 2022, Emma Morgan knowingly possessed an open container in the passenger area of a motor vehicle in Grayson County, Texas. Count 2 alleges that Emma vehicle consumed and possessed alcohol on April 29, 2022 at a time when Emma Morgan was under the age of 21 in violation of Title 4, Section 106.04 and Title 4, Section 106.71. These offenses charged in count one and two are Class C misdemeanors. Ms. Morgan, the state of Texas has a zero policy for alcohol-related offenses by minors, including consuming or possessing alcoholic beverages. Okay, scheduling order has been provided to counsel. Unless I hear otherwise, this case is set for trial on May 27th. I will enter a plea of not guilty for the defendant at this time. Okay, if there's nothing else, we'll be adjourned. Thank you. Okay, State of Texas versus Cody Mitchell, cause number 2022-CR-0911. We're here for an arraignment on an indictment filed with the 397th District Court of Grayson County. Are the parties ready to proceed?
Yes, Your Honor, the state is ready.
Defense is ready, Your Honor.
Okay. Has the defendant been provided with a copy of the indictment in this case?
Yes, Your Honor. He's been provided with a copy of the indictment. I went over it with him. He understands what he's charged with.
Mr. Mitchell, I'm going to read the charges in the indictment for the record and make sure that you're fully notified of the offenses that you've been charged with and the penalties that apply to those charges. I see you're represented by defense counsel for the arraignment. If you have any questions, please wait until the reading is completed and you've had a chance to talk to your attorney before you ask me any questions. Mr. Mitchell, you've been charged in a three-count indictment. Count one alleges that on April 29th, 2022 in Grayson County, Texas, Cody Mitchell operated a motor vehicle in a public place at a time when he was intoxicated and by reason of that intoxication caused the accidental death of Jacob Lester in violation of Texas Penal Code Title 10, Section 49.08. So, Mr. Mitchell, you were charged in count one with intoxication manslaughter. Count two alleges that on April 29, 2022, in Grayson County, Texas, Cody Mitchell operated a motor vehicle in a public place at a time when Cody Mitchell was intoxicated, and by reason of that intoxication, Cody Mitchell caused the accidental death of Connor Clark in violation of the Texas Penal Code Title 10, Section 49.08, intoxication manslaughter. Counts one and two, Mr. Mitchell, are felonies of the second degree. That means each of those counts carries a penalty of imprisonment of from 2 to 20 years and a possible fine of up to $10,000. Do you understand the charges that I've read to you and the possible penalties that apply?
Yes, Your Honor.
Do you or your attorney have any questions?
No, Your Honor, we have no questions.
So, Mr. Mitchell, if you want to make bail, you're going to have to post $75,000 worth of bond. I will tell you also on a case of this nature, if you get released on bond, there will be certain conditions out of my court that you'll have to comply with. One of them will be that if you choose to drive a vehicle at all, it'll be equipped with a deep lung device. That means you won't be able to operate the vehicle until you provide a breath sample every time you want to get in the car. I'll also probably require that you report possibly to a bond officer about once a week. You understand?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. Have both parties had the opportunity to look at the scheduling order? And is there any problem with the scheduling order as it stands?
The state's had an opportunity to review it, Your Honor, and there's no objection or issues from the state.
The defense has had an opportunity to review it as well, Your Honor, and we have no issues.
Okay. Case is set for pretrial on May 2nd, 2022. All motions due on April 25th, 2022. We'll have trial on May 23rd, 2022 if the parties don't resolve this before trial. Anything further?
No, Your Honor.
No, Your Honor.
Okay. Based on these circumstances, we'll proceed with the plea of not guilty until any other plea is entered or there's any further action in this case before trial. Thank you.
Thank you, Judge.
Thank you, Judge.
Jacob died April 29, 2022 as a result of injuries sustained in a head-on collision with a drunk driver. He is survived by his parents and younger brother. Jacob loved sports, was an academic scholar. Jacob received an academic scholarship to Oral Roberts University, where he planned to attend in the fall. He will be greatly missed by his peers and family. Connor died at the hospital April 29, 2022, as a result of injuries sustained from a head-on collision. He is survived by his mother and father and older sister, his beloved dog Zeus, and his Mimi and Pawpaw, who are a huge part of his life. Through his gift of organ donation, he was able to touch the lives of two other individuals. SHS football coach Corey Kane said, "There is a hole in the heart of our football program that cannot be replaced. Connor and Jacob were amazing young men who were leaders of our football team, baseball team, and the Sherman High School campus. Their impact will last a lifetime. We are heartbroken." Emma was convicted of possession of alcohol in a motor vehicle by a minor and consumption of alcohol under the age of 21. Both are Class C misdemeanors. She will have to attend an alcohol awareness course with fines of $500 per offense for a total of $1,000. If she does not attend, her driver's license will be suspended. Cody was convicted of operating a motor vehicle while intoxicated and two counts of intoxication manslaughter and one count of intoxication assault. He received 10 years in prison for each offense. He will have to spend 30 years in prison and will not be eligible for parole for at least 15 years.